One of the things I'm excited about with this interview airing on May 24th, mm-hmm. your family having a legacy of your uncle winning the Indy 500 on May 24th, your dad winning the Indy 500 on May 24th, you winning the Indy 500 on May 24th. Now today, May 24, is about 1 year of sobriety for you. Is that correct?
Correct. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I was, as you were talking, you know, there's those cages that you're talking about, those freedoms to be enjoyed. And, you know, I've had a number of cages that have kept me from having freedom, and one of them is substance use disorder that I've been challenged with for many years. You know, my actual sobriety journey started back in 2002. You know, a long time ago, and I've struggled with this, you know, where I think I've got it, and which earlier I talked about a higher power and that sort of thing. And in those years, you know, I would be doing so well, and then, you know, all of a sudden something would catch me off guard, and I'd go back to it, and that, you know, it was, it's hard. It's a hard disorder to have, and so the one thing that I didn't have, I believed in God, but I didn't have a relationship with God. Okay, and there's a difference. And what happened, you know, with Jesus, has there was a gap with God and me in the past. And, you know, I have sinned, I've done things wrong, you know, all this kind of stuff. And, you know, God is just everywhere and all at once. And I didn't know how to relate. I didn't know how to hook up with him.
Right.
And so, you know, in church with you, and quite honestly, at Connection Point, it's taught me that Jesus is that bridge.
That's right.
Jesus is that bridge. And so once I believed in Jesus, that he died for my sins, and I'm forgiven, I'm redeemed, I'm anointed. You know, once I started believing in that, and I'm going, wow, then all of a sudden I started having a relationship with God. And so the freedoms became more than just fear of death. You know, the freedoms became in life and how to live life and so on. And so, you know, which, you know, with my disorder that I have, you know, it's one day at a time.
That's right.
And so the devotionals, one day at a time. This really has helped me with a relationship with God. And so, you know, you asked me what would be one of my favorite scriptures or whatever. And so, you know, I'm so new to this. I'm learning the Bible and that sort of thing. And really the strongest one that really comes to my mind is John, and it's 14:6. You know, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
That's right.
And so when I thought about that, I went, that's the gap. That's the bridge. That's if I believe in God, then I need to believe in his Son.
That's right.
Who died for me on the cross and died for my sins. And if I believe in Jesus, and I started believing in Jesus, and all of a sudden these new freedoms that I never realized I was even in a cage started coming. And I'm going, wow, because the freedom is so important. And, you know, now that I've been on this time sober for more than a year now, the freedom from that is huge. You know, and it hasn't been the first time. You know, I've gone stints before, but there's been something missing, something missing, and now I really feel that I've found that that's something that's missing, and it's through Jesus Christ.
Yeah.